sports fans, welcome to a new episode of your Jets Connected franchise here on Got Next Gaming. It is week two of our NFL season here in our playthrough of Owner Mode. I want to apologize for taking so long to bring this to you guys. I was completely sick for an entire week. As a matter of fact, I am still not over it 100%. I am going to probably struggle to get through this, but I'm going to do it in the interest of football and you guys. So, we have a lot to discuss here. We're going to go into some of our training here and game planning for the Bills. They're 1-0 and we're 0-1. We took a loss there in week one, and it's a heartbreaking loss, but it was a loss nonetheless. We're going to do things a little bit differently here for this one, but first, we're going to see what the coaches have to say about practice.
Watched the film from yesterday, and I hope everyone knows it wasn't good enough. Today's practice has got to be great. You want to win a ball game, take advantage of your practice reps, because Sunday's going to be here before you know it.
So there you have it. Got to take advantage of practice, because after all, practice makes perfect. We're going to see one play here quickly, a completion to Brandon Marshall.
Hey man, that was great. I mean, you had a great day today. The game is really starting to slow down for you, isn't it? I can't wait to see what you're going to do on Sunday. Good job.
And some high praise from the coaches there as we get ready to take on the Bills. 81 overall to our 77. Going there and playing against the Bills up there in Buffalo has always been a tough chore for the Jets. They always seem to struggle at the when they're on the road there playing against Buffalo. But we're going to see what we can do here with this one. So took that loss last week. We did that play the moments thing. I'm going to kind of go away from that. I'm going to play the full game here and see how we fare, if we fare any better. I felt like I gave up too much control over the game in key situations. I mean, I know it's supposed to be play the moments, but I felt like I could have, if I kind of had the control of the entire game, I could have done a little bit better. And we're going to see how things turn out for this one. We are definitely going to take control of the whole game. So here comes Ryan Fitzpatrick, 228 yards, a touchdown, and an interception. Coming in here, we're going to take the ball first, and we're going to line up from the 25 as we start off our first carry from scrimmage. Here is going to be a run play, and Forte is going to pick up a good 10 yards on the play there, but they're going to mark it just shy of the first down and make it second in inches. So third down and 14 here a little bit later on. Fitzpatrick dropping back to throw, throws deep and tries to hit Brandon Marshall, but he's unable to complete the pass there, and that'll bring up a fourth down and 14. Despite the effort of Marshall going up to fight for the ball, the defender was right there with him, though, so nothing doing there. But here we're going to take a look at the Bills offensive line and then their wide receivers and running backs here. I like that animation. That's a cool aspect that they've added to the game. Let's see what Buffalo does with their possession here as they complete a pass to Clay right over the middle to get the first down and move the chains. So now we have a first down and 10 here, and they're on their own 46, looking to cross over into Jet territory. And let's see what Taylor can do with the ball. See if the Jet defense can stop him. Taylor rolls out a little bit, hits Sammy Watkins, who's wide open against Buster Screen, takes it all the way. Touchdown, Buffalo Bills. Completely misplayed on that one. Sammy Watkins got free for a 54-yard touchdown pass, and we're going to have to keep our eyes on him. Otherwise, he's going to just make us look silly. He cuts to the outside and just gets the step on Buster Screen, and that's all it takes. But the Jets take over here in the first quarter with 4 minutes left to play. We'll hand off to Forte, who gets stopped and jammed right there at the line and actually loses a yard despite his efforts there. So we're going to take a look at the Buffalo defense now. I think I'm going to bring this for all the teams that we play against. We'll bring this little animation in when it shows it, because it's really cool that they do this. I really love this aspect of it. It kind of gives it a real, like, TV production presentation to it. Anyway, third down and 11 here. Fitzpatrick will throw. Hits Amaro. Tries to break the tackle. Does he get enough for the first down? No, he does not. It's fourth down in inches. But you know what, folks? We're going to go for it, because that's the way we're going to play things. That's right. Get Forte. He's going to fight. He gets stopped right away, but does get enough to move those chains and get the first down for the Jets there on their own 36-yard line. 2.5 left in the first. Now we're down under a minute. Fitzpatrick from the shotgun. Third down and 3. Hits Decker across the middle. Gets the first down and more. Moving him into Bills territory now. And getting that first down to pick up an extra set of downs. Let's see the quick replay there. Yeah. Hits Decker in stride. Not a bad pass there. 20 seconds left in the first. First down and 10. throws deep, and it's picked off. He completely underthrew that one. Bad read on the play there, but great read for the Buffalo defense and Graham, who comes up with the interception. That's Fitzpatrick's first interception of the day. And hopefully that's the only one he gets, because we're going to have to do something now with this short field that they have here on a second down and 5. Taylor's looking to throw, and he does. Launches it to Sammy Watkins, who makes the catch before stepping out of bounds. And he'll get the first down there. We have a third down and 3 here now on the 12-yard line, way down in Jets territory. Can we stop him here and hold him to just a field goal? Would be awesome, but nope. LeSean McCoy is going to break right through the line. That amazing, amazing defensive line gets right through there, uncontested, untouched, and walks right into the end zone for a touchdown. So now it is 14-0, and we have the ball on third down and 10, and there's Decker. Goes up and makes a catch there. Does get the first down, so that's a big catch there to keep the chains moving for the Jets from our own 47. Fitzpatrick looking to throw. Does hit Decker again on the curl, picking up another first down and moving it down a little bit more into Buffalo territory. 4 catches, 46 yards for Decker so far. Third down and 12 here, Fitzpatrick. A lot of these third and longs, that one will be batted away and almost picked off, but it'll bring up fourth down and 12, and we are going to be forced here to punt. No way we're going for it in this situation. You just cannot take the chance there, but looks like we're within range there. We got a 57-yard field goal, but the wind is at our backs, and it's a pretty strong wind. Folk will put it up, and he has enough leg, and it's right on target. Field goal, 57-yarder. That's amazing right there to put some points on the board. And we're going to need those points with 4 minutes left here in the half to make it 14-3. But Buffalo has the ball, and they've got plenty of time to march downfield the way they have been. We're able to stop LeSean McCoy on that one. Thankfully, as Jenkins, the rookie, comes in there, Jordan Jenkins, and makes the stop. We'll take a look at the 2016 draft class quickly, as Jenkins is one of our starters out there. And I'm thinking about upgrading the defense, I got to be honest. But here we are, Taylor's getting chased down, is able to make the throw. Watch this crazy play. Ball's batted up in the air, and then it's picked off by Gilchrist. We get the interception on our own. That was one of the craziest plays I've ever seen in Madden. I'm going to tell you the truth, folks. It's not the only one in this game. I'm going to give you a little bit of a spoiler and let you know. But third down and 1 here. Fitzpatrick's looking to throw. Gets Amaro, who's all by himself, is able to get downfield, gets that first down, and a lot more, and gets it into Buffalo territory. Hopefully we can run it down for a touchdown or at least a field goal to get some more points on the board for us. That would be super helpful if we could do that here with just 2 minutes left to play in the half now. And Buffalo with that commanding 14-3 lead. And they've just been dominating us here so far. So that first down and 10 now, and we're going to throw it, and it's going to be picked off by Gilmore, as Fitzpatrick just completely underthrows Marshall, does not even finish the route. I got to tell you the truth, folks. At this point, after this second interception, I was feeling a lot of pressure as Fitzpatrick was being chased down a lot. I couldn't find many open guys. I just didn't know what was going on the offensive side of the ball. Second down and 4 here with just under a minute to play. Taylor will fumble the ball. It is picked up by Riley as he was sacked and loses the ball on that one. We get the fumble recovery with under a minute left to play, and Fitzpatrick's going to toss this one way downfield deep, and Marshall comes down with it. With 46 seconds left, we don't have any timeouts left, and we've got to get this one going. We're going to try to do a quick play action into the end zone, but nope, guess what? Picked off. We did a little jump ball there with not much time left. We were feeling the pressure. We had no timeouts. And let me explain a little bit about that no timeout situation. I didn't really show it here because I didn't want to make it too long for this. But it was a challenge on a play, and we called the challenge, but I didn't call the challenge. It was automatically called, and we lost the challenge and took my timeout away. Last timeout that I could have used. So here we are in the third quarter now. We're in the second half. Taylor gets away. Here's that crazy play that I was talking about where it was fumbled way up in the air. Riley picks up the fumble in midair and is able to run it back for a touchdown. Yeah, we're going to take a little look at that one because this is, like I said, two crazy plays in this game that I could not believe seeing. So there's Taylor. He's sitting back there all day long. He's got the throw. Finally, we break through. He'll take off on the run, being chased down by Jenkins. Jenkins gets in there. He tries to break away. He does break away. Then he's hit by Harris. As he's trying to throw the ball, goes up in the air. Riley picks up the ball midair, then takes off and runs and loses a bunch of diving Buffalo Bills and gets into the end zone for a touchdown. I mean, Do we celebrate? J-E-T-S, Jets, 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 touchdown? Trevor Riley? I mean, really? Like, what the heck kind of play was this? Absolutely insane. But I'll tell you what, it makes for a lot of fun when you're playing the game, for sure. And it definitely brought us within striking distance. Now it's 14-9. Buffalo does have the ball, and they are on their 41-yard line with a third down and 10. We need to stop them here, and we do, as Buster Screen gets a pick off as well. He gets the interception on that one, and he goes up there and makes up for that Sammy Watkins burn play in the first quarter with that touchdown to turn things around and put it back into our favor. So here we are with a second down and 8. Is Patrick looking to throw? But nope. It's as he tries to throw. He fumbles the ball, and now the Buffalo Bills will take this one into the end zone on a fumble for a touchdown. I mean, if this not is not one of the craziest games that I've ever played in my history of playing Madden, I don't know what is. So there's Fitzpatrick again under pressure. He's able to complete the pass to Marshall after Buffalo had that touchdown. Now it's 21-9, by the way, with 2 minutes, a little over 2 minutes left to play in the third. Now we're under 2 minutes. One deep down the field to Decker. Makes the catch in between two defenders. Sometimes I could do it, sometimes I couldn't. Almost a 30-yard catch there, 29 yards on the play. So now we don't get any further in. We're on the 22, looking to get another field goal. And we put it up, and we do get the points as we are now just starting the fourth quarter, and that makes it 21-12. Kind of had to sim the rest of the game here because I ran out of time and did not realize that it was taking me so long to play this particular game, I guess with all the crazy plays that were in it. And I was running out of time to go to work, so I kind of set it to sim and ran off to go get ready for work and get dressed and let the game play itself out. I kind of felt like with the time that I had left that there wasn't going to be much that I could have done to really change things all that much, to be honest, and I was kind of upset about it. Plus, my son was crying in the background as well, and he was kind of distracting me. And like I said, I was here trying to get ready for work too, so we're going to put an end to that one. There was an injury there at the end of it. Didn't really catch it to see who it was, but it was a demoralizing loss for the New York Jets, 21-12 here. Don't know what I'm going to do. I got to be completely honest. There was 4 interceptions in this game by Ryan Fitzpatrick. I had no time to throw. I couldn't find anybody open, and there was, I mean, absolutely nobody open. I was throwing in between defenders half the time. When I did make completions, I mean, 61% wasn't terrible. 257 yards with those 4 interceptions. No touchdowns. It was absolutely, absolutely demoralizing. Couldn't get the run game going as well. And it was just terrible all the way around. I mean, some decent catches out there. Jason Moore had 6 for 58. Decker and Marshall both with 5, 75, and 90 yards respectively. But not much of a good day and not much to be happy about or to take away from this game. I'm definitely going to make some changes in the next episode, without a doubt. We're going to work on that offensive line. I felt like I had pressure from the right side the entire game that I could do nothing with. But that's going to do it for this one, folks. We're going to put it in the books. It's a loss. We're at 0-2. Don't know what we're going to do, but come on back for more Jets action, and I will try to bring that to you as soon as I possibly can. Thanks for stopping by. I'll see you around the channel, and goodbye now.